Hi guys, this is Sadef from Drupal.com, and in this video we'll show you how to debloat and remove bloatware from your OnePlus 12 phone via ADB commands. Rooting is not required. We just have to type in a few lines of ADB command and then our task stands complete. So with that said, still take a backup of all the data on your phone and then let's get started. Do note that I'm using a separate OnePlus phone, it's not a OnePlus 12, but that's not a cause of concern. The steps are applicable across the OnePlus 12, and I have got a list of all the pre-installed apps on the OnePlus 12 phone, so you may easily get this job done via this guide. I am using a phone, it's the OnePlus 9 Pro, just to show you for the sake of reference, but the exact same steps are applicable across the OnePlus 12 as well. It's just that the list of command will be different, the list of apps are different, and I've given a list of all those apps for the OnePlus 12 in my guide. So on that note, let's get started. First and foremost, you will have to set up the ADB shell environment on your phone. So go to the settings menu, then go to about phone, and then you have to tap on build number 7 times. This will enable developer option on your phone. Once that is done, go to system developer option and enable the toggle next to USB debugging. You will get a prompt on your phone, tap on OK. If you are enabling debugging for the first time, you might get an RC key prompt as well. In that case, tap on allow, and with that debugging is enabled. Let's verify the same. So for that, get hold of Android SDK platform tools and extract them onto your PC. You could extract them anywhere you want. In my case, I have done the extraction in C drive, and these are the files of platform tools. Once you have done the extraction, now type in cmd in the address bar and hit enter. You will get a command prompt inside platform tools. If that does not happen, open cmd from the start menu, then type in cd space, cd is for chain directory, copy the platform tools path and paste it here, and we are now inside the platform tools directory. Now type in ADB devices and make sure that you are getting an ID. If you are not getting an ID, or if you are getting an offline keyword, then unlock your phone and again unplug your phone from the PC and then replug it back in. And now let's verify the same. And now we are getting the device keyword. If you are still facing any issue, then disable and re-enable USB debugging. Tap on revoke USB debugging. Use the official USB cable that came with your phone and use the USB 2.0 port on your PC. So carry out these USB tweaks and make sure that you're getting an ID. Once you're getting an ID, you could now enable the ADB shell environment. So for that, type in ADB shell and you will either get your phone name, which is the OnePlus 12, or the phone code name, which is Waffle. I have verified the code name from this post, official OnePlus Reddit post, the wiki post, and the OnePlus 12 is known as Waffle. So you should either get Waffle or your phone name, which is the OnePlus 12. Once that is done, we could now proceed ahead and remove the app from your phone. So this is the list of all the pre-installed apps on your phone. These are the all the Android apps, then these are the Google apps, these are the OnePlus apps and a few other apps, and these are the experimental stuff that might be a little bit a cause of concern if you remove them. So it's a safer approach to not to install them. Do know that this is the list of all the apps that are pre-installed on your phone, and it's not recommended to blindly remove all these apps. You should at least first go through the app package name of these apps. For instance, you could see this is the Android feedback app. So if you don't give the feedback to the developers, then you may easily remove the app. Likewise, if you are not using the calendar app, then you may remove the calendar app from here as well. But apart from that, let me show you some example of any other apps. This is the Android app, and over here you might get an option for cell broadcasting receiver. So it might be the case that it transfers or receives the networking. So if you are not sure, then it's a better approach to leave this app on your phone itself. So you may keep a track of this app from the app package name. And apart from that, we have a few Qualcomm apps as well. As you could see, the Qualcomm apps are quite important. So I will advise you to not interact with these apps and leave them as they are. And then if you're using the Lineage OS ROM on your OnePlus 12, then you may remove the few Lineage OS apps as well from here. And these are the few AOSP ROMs, and you may remove these apps from here if you want. And apart from that, these are the stocks app from the Google apps, OnePlus apps, and the Android apps that you may remove if you want. You may also get hold of all these app packages on your OnePlus 12 by simply typing in pm list packages and hit enter, and this will bring up a list of all your apps which are there on your OnePlus 12 phone. But as of now, you could see that all these apps are mixed. So what you could do is you could also segregate the apps based on the developer. For instance, if you want to see the apps only from Google, so in that case you may type in the command pm list packages space Google and hit enter, and it will now only bring up the apps which are part of the Google apps. As you could see, this is the command and these are all the apps which are from the Google only. So you, in the same way, you may get hold of all the other apps from a particular developer. Once you have got the required app, let's show you how to remove the app. So for the sake of reference, let me use any app. So let's go with the pre-installed app. So the YouTube app might also be pre-installed on your phone, and this is the app package name for the YouTube app, and this is the entire command. So whatever app you want to uninstall from your phone, you just have to copy the command and paste it in the CMD window. So for instance, I am uninstalling the YouTube app. As of now, this is the YouTube app installed on my phone. As you could see from here, it's currently installed. So I will now uninstall the app. Let me show you the app package name, and this is the app icon on the home screen as well. You will now see the app being removed from my phone. So simply I have to copy the entire command and paste the command in the CMD window and paste it, hit enter, and you will get a success message. And as you could see, the app has been removed from our phone. It's no longer there, and the YouTube app is no longer there on your phone. In a similar manner, you may remove all the other app of your choice. And if you end up removing an app but it is now leading to the OS not working along the expected line, or if you want to reinstall that app back, then it's quite easy. You just have to use a single line of command and the app will be back onto your phone. So there might be a few instances wherein if you uninstall an app, then the OS or some of its feature might not work as expected. So in that case, simply use this command and then the app will be reinstalled. So you just have to change the package name with the app package name. So in my case, I had used this command wherein the package name was com Google Android YouTube. So what I have to do is use this command, but simply replace the package name with the YouTube package name. So this is the package name for YouTube. Let me remove the package name and replace it with the YouTube package name. Once that is done, let me now show you the app will now be installed onto my phone. Keep a track at the bottom, it will be installed. So I just have to now copy this command and paste it in the CMD window and hit enter. And as you could see, the app is now installed and I got the YouTube app on my phone. Let me launch it, and I could now easily use the app without any issues. So guys, you may get hold of all the apps either from this list, or you may simply type in the PM list packages and you will get a list of all the apps installed on your phone, or you may type in PM list packages space the name of the developer such as Google, and then you will get the apps only from a particular developer such as Google, Samsung and all such OEMs. Apart from that, if you want to remove any app, then simply copy the command and hit enter. Likewise, you may reinstall any app of your choice as and when required by simply using the command, this command. Simply replace the package name with the app package name and your task stands complete. Again, I am repeating, make sure to double check the app that you are removing and make sure that it's not an important system app, because otherwise it might lead to a few issues. Although you have the option to reinstall the app, but it's better to be on the safer side. So guys, on that note, I round off this video. If you have any queries with regard to any of the steps, do let me know in the comment section, and thanks a lot for watching.